Hello, and welcome to our webinar about SEMS. SEMS is a smart energy management system designed for PV power plants. There are many great functions and features like data presentation, main dashboard, reports, alarms, and more. Today, we want to invite you to walk through the procedure and learn how to create and manage plants on the SEMS in just a few minutes. The link of SEMS is www.semsportal.com. At this page, we can click on Demo to check example plants, which are for monitoring only. Here is the language option. We currently have 11 different languages available, with more becoming available shortly. To use SEMS, you'll need a proper account. And there are different ways for distributors and installers and end customers to get their accounts. For example, as an installer, I should contact my distributor first and ask them to create the account. Next, I will receive an email from SEMS, which includes my account name and temporary password. Here is my email. Next, click on the first link to confirm and change your password as required. Okay, I've logged in, but the homepage is empty. So the next step is we need to create some power plants. This is the plant creation page. Under owner, we should put in the email address of the plant owner. If necessary, we can also add some visitor email to grant access to others. Then we will work on the plant information. There are a few items with red star marks. Plant name capacity, location, and profit ration, which I have to enter in to complete the process. Since I'm using my installer account to create the plant for my customer, my installer or distributor code is here by default. Okay, everything is done and confirmed. We can click on Submit. We have created an empty plant. Next step, we will add the device into it. The serial number and check code can be found on the inverter's label. If you have multiple inverters installed on the same system, or multiple plants in different locations, we can just repeat the previous steps. Plant creation is now done. Let's check on how to monitor our plants. We're back to the homepage again. The four blocks demonstrate overall picture of the plants under my account, including plant performance and status. For example, these four different colors tell four different plant statuses. Gray means the plant is offline. Green means normal status. Moreover, I can rank my plants according to their capacity and generation. It can be display plants in different classification by selecting residential, commercial rooftop, or ground mounted. Even more convenient and quicker, I can locate specific plants using the search function, such as plant name or serial number. This is my plant. I can click on the name and enter into single plant page. This part is basic information, including capacity and location of the plant. This part demonstrates real-time status, generation, and income of the plant. There are curves, charts, and exportable data, which can give us more details of the plant performance. Let's move the devices in this plant. From here, we are able to know inverter's operation status, today's generation, general parameters, AC outputs, and DC inputs. When I click on curve, we can see more operational details of this inverter over a period of time. In addition, I can export the data for future reference. This inverter is offline right now. Let's check it on alarms management page. At this page, all plants and error status are listed here. When I click on details, we can find which inverter and which plant has what error during what time. Plus, these errors are arranged according to the warning level and status. We can also find analysis of the occurrence of such error and get troubleshooting advice and more details as well. Another basic but great function is reports, which includes historical data, generation reports, and statistics. We've reached the end of the video. You should now have a basic overview of how SEMS looks and how it works. But there are a lot more functions and features to discover, such as organization management, auto device detection, load monitoring, and weather station monitoring. Any questions after watching this video? Any good ideas on what should come next? Please comment here or contact us directly. Thank you.